Hello everyone and welcome back to Joy's Creative Finger. This weekend I decided to build a rustic mansion and it belongs to Lillian's sister. Now Lillian, if you don't know who she is the mistress to Jeffrey, who is Chrissy's husband in our Let's Play Families. That's an AR Let's Play series that's running on the channel. Now Lillian is in a dilemma. She's just discovered that her lover is actually married and she has come to visit her sister. She's a bit devastated and you'll see it in the season finale, which is the Christmas episode due to come out in a couple of days time. Now she's actually here visiting her sister who's preparing for Christmas, and this is a rustic mansion that her sister lives in. Her sister is here with her boyfriend and another girlfriend for a pre-Christmas dinner of some sort. You know, there's a lot of parties and festivities that take place during this time of the year, so this is one of those. And Lillian is in the house. Now, as I say, it's a rustic mansion. You can see from the outside that I have used some of the wildflowers that we've unlocked during this current running seasonal missing claws quest. We have about 3 days left if you're watching in real time, but I've used those wildflowers and mixed and matched them with other flowers that we've had in the game and these hedges from the French Romance update. Now I've used them to wrap around the preteen water glides, and the fountains look realistic because of the spray outs that you can see. And I was inspired to do this because I had seen something similar on the front part of a house that I had seen on the architect tab, and I think it was lovely. So I came up with my arrangement as you see here, and it works. For me, it does anyway. Now we're touring in snow mode, and I'm glad I have a snowman out here because the grid doesn't allow me to place a snowman. I've used up all the space for all the gardening that you see and so on. And one thing I wanted to say is, as you can see for the shape of the front of the house, these windows are empty. They don't really reflect the outside of the house. It's purely decorative, as you would a one by one pillar, just to make the house look beautiful and have a more interesting shape. So I've carried on with the wildflowers wrapping around through to the back part of the house. It's on a small plot. I've gotten used to building on small plots. Don't worry, I will build on large ones, but I'm used to it because of AR. So I just about have a backyard. There's a space for the fridge and the pizza grill out here, and we have a 4x1 grid bifold double door that leads out there, so it's nice and spacious from the main living room area, and we have a pool. So I tried my best to make sure that there was some sort of grounds around, and then of course have a home built on it at the same time. So you're gonna see what it looks like inside, and you can let me know what you think in the comments down below with how I've used my space. Right, so you've got this lovely grand entrance as you walk through, and we have this French door. I like the brown on the front, and when you walk in on the left you have a nice big sizable bathroom. And it's interesting because, as I say, I've used up a lot of space here and I still managed to have good sized rooms. So small plots get a bad rap, but I don't think they should. You can get creative and make something of it. So it's a full bathroom, and then on the other side we have the kitchen. Now this is where I had to really try and make it work, because it's a small kitchen, so it's somewhat open plan as you turn left when you come into the house. I've gone for white and soft pale colors so that there is an illusion of much more space. It looks like a galley kitchen, but it's open plan and it flows right through with a double door through to where you have the entrance. The units are from the Brilliant Backyard event, and there's actually a small fridge in there. Now the other thing I did was use a demarcation of windows between the dining and the kitchen, creating more of an openness as well, so the kitchen doesn't feel claustrophobic. Now this is my dining room, and you can see the family is here. You've got Lillian, you've got her sister sitting right by her with the red updo, and you've got her fiancé, which is opposite Lillian anyway, and she's here talking to them about what she's just experienced, but she's not making a big deal of it. She's just saying that she found out that the guy she was dating, who should have joined her for dinner here today, turns out to be married. Her sister's quite disappointed standing up here, and you know, she's happy at this time with her fiancé sitting here in the black suit, You've got Chandra, her soon-to-be maid of honor as well. It was meant to be a happy time where they would sit down and meet each other's fiancé. But Lillian has showed up without her plus one. This is what I've got, the back here in the dining room area. It's beautiful, soft, and understated, but really nice and classy. And yes, it's all part of the kitchen in a way, but it's still separate. Now you come through and you have this lovely grand piano underneath this beautiful candelabra. I think it's lovely. And then you have the bifold double doors I spoke about earlier. So when you open it up, between the room and the backyard, there's a bit of space. So yes, there's not that much of a backyard, but it works with the big door and the connection that it makes. Now this is where the living room is. We have the rustic fireplace, the Christmas tree, the presents. This rustic fireplace creates shape to the room. It does. You know, you've got the corners and the back tucked away where you've got the plants, you've got a lamp and so on. You've got the little basket with wood in it. It's just fantastic. It's nice. And I'm so glad that we have it. And then you've got the wraparound seats, the bookshelves and a siding chest of drawers with plants on it. It felt really cozy. I really love the idea of how it came together there. And then you've got the staircase that goes up to the living quarters. So I'm just going to get Lillian to come up. And there is a particular reason why Lillian still showed up, even though she knew that her, so to say, plus one was no longer available. But she definitely wanted to come here. And we'll find out why, partly. So you come up this corridor and again, over on the right hand side, right above the bathroom downstairs, we have a family bathroom. And I wanted it to be modern and different from the bathrooms that I would usually create. And it's quite a big space, isn't it? I mean, again, this is on a small plot, big rooms, but what you have is that there isn't like a big landing and another sitting room upstairs. But that's the main family bathroom, as you can see there. Across the hall, you come into the first guest room, and there she's come through, and there's full access to both sides of the bed. And it's your typical, lovely, rustic space. And over on the side here, you have a wardrobe. So everything required is in here. The room doesn't belong to anyone in particular. If Lillian stayed the night, she would stay in one of these rooms. It's a three-bedroom house owned by her sister and fiancé. And so they would use the rooms for whatever they would want when they become a couple. So this is the next room, similar design, different furniture, and there is a wardrobe as well. So it's fully functional and there's space for everything that you need and nice windows for a good view. Across the corridor, you come through to this beautiful, compact office space. Now, this is the reason why Lillian is here. There is a white box that is hidden in the middle of this bookcase. There's something in it that she wants, that she needs, and she's going to take it, unknown to the occupants of this house. You'll find out what she took in the next episode of Let's Play Families, the season finale. So it's coming out in a couple of days, don't worry. Just for Christmas, right? This is the master bedroom. It's beautiful. Love the color combination. I think it's nice and different. I tend to go for pinks a lot, so the walls are a bit bluey gray in a way. And the big window is on the side here, so the room is really private and, you know, not exposed to the outside in any way. And then you walk through in past that big window and you have the closet space here, so you can get changed in the privacy of this corner, and you can then work your way through to the bathroom, or you could work your way the other way around. So you take a shower, right? And then after taking a shower or brushing your teeth and basically getting thoroughly cleaned up, you can then work your way back out to the closet space, get dressed, and then make your way around to the main bedroom and out the door and out to work or wherever it is that you go. And this is the floor plan for this master bedroom. I think it's lovely, and I think I'm really happy with the job that I had done with the spaces, because I think initially when we started having premium plots, well, we didn't start having them, we just had premium plots, but you had this built up expectation to unlock the premium plots and to make use of them, and it felt like, oh, you were restricted in some way. But of course you are restricted, but you can still go ahead to create something that is realistic. I mean, it's a real house with proper dimensions and space for everything that you need or want in a property of any kind. This looks like a manor in a way, but it's not traditional, it's modern. So she's having a little chat with her brother-in-law, to-be, because she just felt startled that she came down the stairs and there he was, and she has sneaked into her pocket something that belongs to him that was in her sister's office. Let's close that door. And yeah, this is the floor plan. Would you like a life build for this? Let me know in the comments down below. Let me know what you think about what Lillian presumably has stolen from the house, what she's going to do with it, what's going on. Thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned for the next episode of Let's Play Families in a couple of days. It's the season finale. Don't miss it. Take care, and I'll see you again soon. Bye.